Hey, I'm Scott Hanselman. This is another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Dan Taylor, and we're going to talk about application insights and debug snapshots.
That's right.
Love it.
So, Scott, have you ever had this problem where you're having an issue in production, and you just can't figure out what's going wrong, and you spend all this time having to reproduce, you know, pull the data down and come up with that local environment?
You don't know my life, Dan. You don't know my, yes, basically always.
Always, yeah. So our goal with the snapshot debugger and application insights is to automatically capture a full debug snapshot when those exceptions in production get thrown so that you don't need to reproduce the issue. You can get the access to the variables and get more of a sort of that intuition about what the problem was.
You said production, though.
Yes.
Because you're using the words debug and production in the same sentence, it's making me uncomfortable.
Yes, but we put the word snapshot in front of it. It's a different kind of debugging, right? Uh-huh. So we're kind of saying, we want you to get that same capability that makes you productive in your local environment, but safe for production. So the way it works is that we actually take a fork of the running process, so to speak, in production when that exception gets thrown. We sit there and we monitor the production environment. We see exceptions are getting thrown. So we take a quick fork. It takes only about 10 milliseconds. And to get a little bit technical, it makes just a copy of the process page table, which is only about 100 kilobytes.
Okay.
So there's not that much overhead added to the production environment. Meanwhile, we make a copy of that process memory and upload it to Application Insights.
Okay. So to use a cheesy analogy so that I might understand with my small brain, you've got this freeway, which is production, and cars are breaking down.
Yep.
Rather than stopping the freeway and having a traffic jam, you're sending them off on kind of generated exit ramps.
That's
right. So you get anybody who's having an error, you get them off of production, and we can work on them on the side of the road without having to affect anyone.
It's almost like a pit stop at a...
Yeah, it's a pit stop.
Yeah.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So this isn't going to slow things down. This is only good things.
That's right.
Cool. So do I have this already?
So you can use this today. If you're using Application Insights, and I'll show this a little bit later, you can add a NuGet package to your application, which will do the monitoring of the snapshot generation, which is publicly available, and I'll show you how you can do that in Visual Studio.
And is this a .NET thing primarily, or is it a Node
thing?
Yeah,
this is a .NET and .NET Core. They're both supported. So, yeah.
All right.
Same steps work for both. Okay, so... let's just start. I'm going to start and show you kind of what the working scenario looks like, and then I'll go back and show you how to set it up. So I've got this application here, my visitors application. It's our favorite application. So we can go in here.
It's a real app, though.
This is a real app, and I've got it running right here.
Okay.
You know, it's kind of still running there online.
Okay.
And I've got, I'll show you the failure. I've got this this fellow Dan here. When you try and look at his profile, it says there was an error, right? So someone comes to you and says, hey, your website's not working for me, and what do you do? Well, if we come to Application Insights, I like to start with the application map in Application Insights because it can show me sort of what layer the failures are happening in.
Okay.
And I can see there's this index out of range exception happening on that that get visitors API there. So if I click that, because I've got the snapshot collector NuGet package added to my application, it automatically collected a debug snapshot on this exception here. Now, you notice it says the index was outside of the bounds of the array. Well, what index, what array, what bounds? You know, there's only so much I can deduce from.
Yeah, but there's no line of code. I'd have to go hunting for it, I guess, is there?
Yep.
No, well, there's a call stack at the bottom that would get me close.
But, you know, you need to know sort of more information about the
I'd like to know everything, frankly. Yeah.
So if I click open that debug snapshot there, it gives me a viewing experience in the portal where I can actually navigate up and down the call stack. And then down below, it's got the local variables. And I can go and expand and look at, you know, this object and, and various information. And I can see this is that Dan Fenwick, same person, publishers.
Well, this is the, and that locals that you, that looks a lot like what I would expect to see if I were doing debug work as a developer inside of Visual Studio. You've given me like the watch window.
That's exactly it. Actually, and it's really interesting, we're actually running the Visual Studio debugger in the cloud right now against the snapshot that we took. So the same.
Oh, and that's how you take apart that DMP file, that dump.
Yeah, exactly. So it's the same sort of capabilities, and so we're able to put this together using a lot of the technology that we already have from Visual Studio.
Okay. So that is an actual debug dump.
Yes.
And I could go and download it and play with it in other tools if I wanted to. But you're doing this in the browser.
Yes, that's correct. So I can show you that we can open this snapshot here, too, with Visual Studio. If I click the download snapshot button, that'll download that. And I've
It's a big file.
It's a big file, but it sort of contains everything. We could trim it down a bit, but then you don't have the full process state. So we've got all the threads, all the variables. You can actually do dump debugging on this, and sort of for the really super tricky hairy bugs that involve, you know, cross-thread dependencies mm-hmm. and things like that.
Well, that's coming down pretty fast, and it is better to have a full dump than a mini dump in that mm-hmm. case. So that comes down as a .diag session.
Right, that's correct. The diag session actually includes all of the symbol files that it found from the production environment. Mm-hmm. So interestingly, we've actually changed the latest version of Visual Studio to start publishing the PDB files, the symbol files, alongside your DLLs. So specifically so that we could capture them and allow you to do that mapping back to source code.
In the past, there was maybe the last 5 or 10 years, there had been talk about whether or not someone should publish a debug version of a .NET application versus a production issue, production version, like mm-hmm. you have debug and release. Mm-hmm. Does this work in either one, and it just has to have your PDB files along for the ride?
That's correct. So release didn't used to publish PDB files, but now it does.
I see.
And the other thing that that if you have the Application Insights instrumentation engine installed, we actually do some sort of magic here at the call site where the exception is thrown. Mm-hmm. Because if you've debugged release builds, you might notice variables start disappearing a lot of the times, and then that's all the information you needed to sort of figure out what was happening.
Right.
So what we do with the instrumentation engine for Application Insights is when we notice the exceptions getting thrown, we actually go in and de-optimize just the function where that exception was thrown from, just so that you can get access to all those local variables when you then go and debug
it. Interesting. That makes sense. Because in production, you're going to have some optimizations and some tail call optimizations,
yep.
some stuff that you want.
Yep.
Optimizations that are there for a point. You don't want to go and, you know, neuter
yeah.
Release. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, you're saying that you locally turn those things off when you notice them, yep. which gives you the best of both worlds.
Right. So we're not de-optimizing the whole thing. We're just a small, you know, one function as part of your code. And then we put it back when we're done.
That is a nice piece of magic. So you double-clicked on the diag session, and it opened up into Visual Studio. Mm-hmm. And what do we see here? So I'm seeing, this is just interesting. I want to just point out, D:\Windows. I know for a fact that you don't have a D drive here.
That's right.
That's D drive in Azure.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
I just think that's so cool. It's just a cool reminder. This is just me geeking out. But
yep.
it's like, wow, there really is an IIS in the cloud. And Azure does have drives and runs Windows.
Yeah, and we try and make it so simple for you so you don't have to worry about all these details.
Yeah.
You know, we take care of all that.
But it's cool to be reminded that you know this stuff.
Yep.
It's just a machine in the cloud, and now it's come locally here, and you can go and start debugging.
Yep, and like I said, you have all the modules are on the D drive as well, and we have mm-hmm. we have the matching symbols for a lot of that stuff as well. So I can click debug with managed only here. Mm-hmm. I can do a few different things depending, but you've got the...
Did you have to open your project ahead of time?
I did have my project open here mm-hmm. ahead of time.
Okay.
So usually, people have a Git commit that tracks their, released production environment.
Okay.
We are working on making that more automatic, but for now,
You just had it open already.
Yep. The big thing was the symbols. So if I click debug with managed only, that'll open it up here in Visual Studio.
Yep. And I just saw the symbols just get loaded, and then there's your locals again.
Yep. There's the locals. Yep. Let me just pull this down here. And so the cool part here is decompose this issue a little bit, right? This looks just like an exception that would get thrown if you pressed
F5.
Well,
it feels like you took the moment in time and you put Visual Studio right at that moment.
Yes,
where it popped the... I'm surprised that popped up.
Yeah, we made it, we actually did extra works to make the exception right at the point where it was thrown rather than sort of in the guts.
You didn't make me push any extra buttons to get to this point.
Right, exactly.
That's the moment.
And you can hover over variables, so if we sort of deconstruct this right here, I see that there is an index out of range exception on this parts array.
Oh, wow.
Right? And I can open the parts array and see that, there's only one element in it, and here I'm trying to access the first element, and it's because I'm sort of generating that parts array by splitting this visitor.security code, and mm-hmm. I can hover over the visitor object and see that, in this case, that was an empty string. So I can now, make a fix to at least guard against this mm-hmm. issue without having to have, try to F5 it locally and pull down the data set from the production environment.
And you said before that this is for .NET full framework and .NET core.
That's
they just have to add the NuGet package.
That's correct. That's correct. So if I come here in my Application Insights, if I just go managed NuGet packages for this application, mm-hmm. I need to stop debugging before it'll let me do that.
Sure.
Just really quickly. So if you have App Insights set up, it's as simple as installing this snapshot collector NuGet package right there, and the same one works for .NET and .NET Core.
Because do I have to hook anything up, or does it just its existence, just being in the project?
It adds some Application Insights config settings. Mm-hmm. So if you have Application Insights, it just adds some additional config variables. And here you can tweak the parameters of how often we collect snapshots, how many, various things like that, whatever you want for your particular environment.
So you optimize for debug versus production, debug versus release. It doesn't really cost anything. Does the storage for the dump files cost me?
Right now, we're taking care of that cost. It's it's a preview feature, so we're taking care of the cost. We'll probably continue to do that for you as a sort of value add.
Right, and then you know if you didn't at some point, it's just storage, which is pennies on the gig. So I'm just trying to think of a reason I would not want to do this, and I'm not coming up with any good reasons. It's not going to slow anything down. It's only going to make things better. And it works with the code I already have.
It's just a little bit of your time, that's all.
Add the snapshot collector and good things happen.
That's correct.
Fantastic. I'm learning about all kind of great stuff that I can do with debug snapshots on Application Insights here on Azure Friday.